We will now take a closer look at importing screens, placing them in the 3D space and some different settings. So I will just activate the grid so that we can see the 3D space. And then I will import a generic flat screen. Once I select the screen, I can use these handles to adjust the size of the screen. On the right hand side, you can see that we're looking at metric units. We will of course implement inches, etc. for our American customers in the near future. You can directly enter the precise position here, as well as the rotation. If you don't want to use the information on the right-hand side but want to deal directly with the screen, you could also use this rotation icon directly. Here. If you simply click on it, you can change the rotation in steps of 7.5 degrees. However, if you press and hold Shift while you rotate the screen, you can rotate it even more precisely. Another option is to actually move the rotation point by moving the icon. It could be on the actual screen or somewhere else. If you want to rotate the screen via this corner, it's easily done. Depending on how you change the object, your bounding box will also change. By pressing B, you can adjust it to the new position. In order to move the screen in the 3D space, there are some basic points we need to understand. If I look at the screen in such a frontal way, I can only move it along the two highlighted axes, in our case, X and Y. However, once we move to the side, I would have the Z and the Y axes for moving the screen. And if we look at the whole setup from the top, it would be the Z and the X axes. The yellow highlighted line shows you which axis is being used.